a strange series of vertebrae was recently discovered, and was described as the tailbones of Spinosaurus. The tail was thin and most likely was used for swimming. A new study about this fossil describes Spinosaurus as an aquatic predator, one that lived and hunted in water. But this depiction of the animal is a precarious one. Spinosaurus is an ichthyosaur, or any of the other kinds of marine reptiles. It's a dinosauria, in particular a tetanurine theropod, and members of this clade have been known to be strictly terrestrial. This tail might be the most extreme aquatic adaptation ever seen in a theropod dinosaur, and although Spinosaurus could swim, an aquatic lifestyle was anything but certain. Spinosaurid is a group consisting of approximately 13 genera of theropod dinosaurs. Their fossils have been found from all around the globe, from Southeast Asia, this Ichthyophonator, to North Africa, the infamous Spinosaurus. One similarity they share is their diet of fish. Fossilized remains of various Cretaceous fish are commonly found alongside the Spinosaurid fossils. And the morphological features of its head made it clear that this animal was well suited for catching fish. This indirectly leads to the assumption of the animal being somewhat aquatic. In 2010, an analysis revealed that the oxygen isotopic compositions of Spinosaurus teeth were more similar to those of turtles and crocodilians than to other land-based dinosaurs. The study concluded that Spinosaurus used the freshwater environment as a living habitat. This argument was supported by a major fossil discovery 4 years later. Although still incomplete, researchers were able to create a reconstruction of the animal, and found out that Spinosaurus had morphological features only found on water-dwelling animals, such as shorter hind limbs with adaptations similar to those of early cetaceans, wide and flattened feet reminiscent of flattened paddle angules of shorebirds that do not perch, and possibly webbed like ducks, and an increase in bone mass and density. Unlike terrestrial theropods' bones, Spinosaurus' bones were dense and heavy, as it might assist balance in water. But one adaptation was weirder than the others. In the paper, Spinosaurus' center of mass was calculated to be positioned here, in the rib cage, not in the knee or hip joints. This would better fit the animal in a swimming posture, but it incapacitates it from walking on two legs. And although equipped with robust arms, Spinosaurus could not rotate its forearms for the palm to face the ground. It had to walk on its knuckles. Not a single theropod dinosaur has been described as a knuckle-walking quadruped before. This depiction of Spinosaurus was deemed by many as inaccurate, and a weird posture was an indication of a fallible reconstruction. To be fair, the reconstruction was an extrapolation of different-sized specimens, scaled to what was assumed to be the correct proportion of a single individual. Had it not been done correctly, the result could turn out to be a chimera. The scarcity of its remains is what makes it so hard to get an unambiguous depiction of this peculiar animal. Spinosaurus fossils are very rare, and all found specimens are partial and fragmented, rendering it basically impossible to accurately reconstruct. However, in 2018, dug out of the Moroccan desert were tailbones with unusual shapes. This finding added a radically aquatic feature to Spinosaurus. The elongated neural spines and chevrons form a fin-like structure. The bones had loose joints and muscle-supporting structures, showing that this tail was used for swimming, paddling through water, and served as Spinosaurus' primary means of aquatic locomotion. The swimming performance of the tail model showed better efficiency and significantly better thrust power compared to other terrestrial theropods' tails, but is still weaker than those of the tail-propelled aquatic tetrapods. This fossil was found in the Kemkem beds, in the same site where the neotype specimen was discovered. And sure enough, osteohistological analysis determined that this new material and the neotype came from a single subadult Spinosaurus individual. This was the missing tail of the same Spinosaurus from 2014. So apparently, Spinosaurus could swim. But in water, its iconic dorsal sail would work against it by generating a lot of wave drag. And unlike other aquatic pursuit predators, its forelimbs did not reduce in size, and in contrast were brawny, making Spinosaurus even less hydrodynamic. The arms must have been actively used to scavenge for food. The positioning of the nostrils does not help Spinosaurus much to breathe while swimming either. Unlike the crocodilians, this nostril placement is more in line with the wading birds. Spinosaurus wasn't particularly built as an aquatic pursuit predator. It simply couldn't outswim its fully aquatic prey. A specimen previously assigned as a separate genus called Sigillmasasaurus has been identified to be a synonym of Spinosaurus. The remains are flexible neck vertebrae, suggesting that Spinosaurus could fold its neck, shifting the center of mass back. This would allow it to comfortably walk and possibly hunt on land. Morphologically, the aquatic adaptations would make Spinosaurus more suited as a shoreline generalist rather than a specialized aquatic predator. Spinosaurus most likely hunted within the shallow waters, waded like a modern-day stork, sensed the flight, and some 10,000 times more massive. Catching prey without submerging its body into the water, occasionally swimming into deeper waters only to get across to another patch of land. This is also consistent ecologically. Cretaceous North Africa was covered in huge systems of rivers and swamps. Being able to freely move from one place to another, either by swimming or walking, gives Spinosaurus an advantage over the environment, allowing it to capture both aquatic and terrestrial prey. Spinosaurus had to share this region with other giant carnivores. In the water, there was this stupidly large crocodile called Sarcosuchus. And Carcharodontosaurus was a highly active land-based hunter that patrolled the dry grounds. The fact that these giant predators could coexist proved that they didn't fight over the same hunting grounds. Spinosaurus had adapted to avoid direct competition over food sources on land or in water, and instead was able to exploit the environment in between, subsequently evolved into a 15-meter-long apex predator, the largest and arguably the weirdest predatory dinosaur ever known.